Morning, lads.
Morning.
Morning, Ray.
Morning.
Got everything under control?
Yes, sir.
Jolly good. Ah, yes, very good. You got them all up?
Yes, sir.
Good, good. Morning, Jim.
Sir.
You all right?
Yes, thank you,
very
sir.
Good.
Might turn out to be the kind of governor who gets to a shout and sits over a stopwatch showing a performing.
Nah, Conway's not a snidey git.
No. Power changes people.
You'll always be the same then, Reg.
It's 01 from Sierra Oscar, receive it, over.
Yeah, receiving.
69 Askill Road, burglary, suspect on premises.
Yeah, on way.
Everything all right, Philip?
Yes, fine, thank you, Derek. What would you prefer, sir?
This is no big deal, you know. But as superintendent of a busy division, acting or otherwise, one of the first things you have to learn is how to delegate. So, can I give you these? There's the Cockcroft Tenants Association Designing Out Crime Working Party and the Gays Against Militarism Rally on Friday.
Thank you.
Thank you, Philip. Oh, I believe this is still your office. See you later. Oh, by the way, are you still on for tonight? Mr. Brownlow's goodbye treat.
Wouldn't miss it for the world, Derek.
Morning, Charles. Welcome to Area. Got everything you want?
I've got the job, sir. What else matters?
You called us, yeah?
Yes, I heard the back window breaking. They're away on holiday.
Hey! Reg!
Sierra Oscar from 363, Askill Road burglary. Suspect decamped in direction of Golding's Crescent. Male, IC1, short, late 20s, wearing a grey jacket and a red baseball cap.
See, still somebody in.
Yeah?
Never seen her before.
She doesn't live here then?
No, they haven't got kids.
So when do they come back from their holidays?
Well, they've got another 2 weeks yet.
Sierra Oscar, 171.
Go ahead, over.
Yeah, we're in Askill Road. Can we have somebody to stand on premises? We've nicked her body. Of sorts.
What's her name?
She's not saying.
She belongs to the burglar, I take it.
Well, she must do. Either that or she was already in the house for some reason, which seems unlikely.
And she wasn't used to break in? Stuff through the letterbox or cat flap?
No, Sarge. That door was forced.
Just along for the ride, then?
Yeah. Scandal, isn't it? Lack of creche facilities for housebreakers.
Right, I'll get on to social services. Take her through to the DVU.
DVU? What for?
She'll have some toys to play with. Not having her here. She might not be house-trained.
Come on.
I know I want villains nicked, but I wasn't anticipating a three-year-old.
Was it your dad took you to that house this morning? He's going to be very worried about you. Should let him know you're safe. Do you know your address?
Hello? My name's Derek. What's your name? Tell her the courts may draw adverse conclusions from her silence.
Oh, sure.
You're right. He's getting about a bit.
Oh, zip me. Don't mind betting. First day's Ed Marcia, can't
you? You didn't say that earlier.
Yeah, but members look a bit else, mate. And I reacted the same when I became Federation rep, you know.
Yeah, well, you're not Fed rep now, so get a cup of tea, will you?
You done that memo for me yet, Marion?
Oh, yes, it's just there, sir.
Thank you.
Now, are you still going to the DIY store?
Yes, of course. Just because I'm not CLO anymore doesn't mean I have to give up the tea and buns, you know. I'll fit it in when I go walkabout.
Now, you haven't forgotten Mr. Lampard, have you?
Yeah.
He's the new leader of the council. He's come to bend your ear at 10:30.
No, of course not. I'm looking forward to bending his, actually.
Initially, you may find your duties here a trifle nebulous. But once the restructuring begins to firm up...
You mean when the axe falls?
You've always shown a high degree of detachment, Charles. The ideal person to put the severed heads in a neat pile. Prior to that, of course, your phone's going to be red hot. Nervous divisional chief supers wanting their fortunes told. And that's another thing you've always been good at, fobbing people off.
Spare a minute, Jack.
Yes, sir.
Hey, don't you start.
Do they fit then, brown light shoes?
No, much too tight. I've thrown them away. Along with the divisional management team. Well, it will still meet, of course, but not once a week. It's a waste of everybody's time telling each other things we already know and listening to admin's plans to introduce cheaper biros. No, once a month from now on. But in the meantime, we still talk to each other. Especially you and Philip Cato. Don't want you throwing your teddies in the corner just because I've had greatness thrust upon me.
Certainly not. Couldn't have happened to a better bloke. You will be increasing CID's budget, though, won't you? Brownlow is always suspicious of the CID, and I'm taking it for granted that you don't share his prejudices.
No, but I'm wondering whether we need CID at all. Talk about it tonight, yeah? Between the soup and fish. Hello, John.
What are you doing?
I'm
just
here.
Keeping her amused. Right. You ever played with this stuff?
Yes.
Yeah, I love it. Do you know what I like doing best? Mm. I like building houses. See this? Right? This is where I live.
There's a door.
Yeah, this is my street, right?
Yeah.
This is my house where I live. It's a big house, isn't it?
Yes.
Big block of flats where lots of people live.
I've got my house over here.
Yeah. And up here.
Yes.
That's where I live. In the blue door. What colour is that? Blue, isn't it?
Blue.
It's number 41. There you go. 41.
One.
Do you want to go?
Come in!
Mr. Lampard, sir.
Ah, good. Show him in, Marion, please. And could you rustle up some coffee, love?
Yes, sir.
Roy, pleased to see you again. Congratulations are in order. Quite a landslide.
Thank you, Derek. Equally in order for you, too.
Sit down. Well, it's the same in the police as in politics, you know. We all get promoted to our level of incompetence. Actually, I was going to seek you out anyway. Just to reassure you that all this restructuring within the Met will not affect the quality of service we deliver here at Sun Hill.
I rather thought the purpose of the restructuring was to improve it. Quality of service.
Well, yes, of course. Yes.
So we can look forward to increased street patrols in the very near future?
Eventually, hopefully, yes, but these things do take a while to shake down.
Which is really why I felt we should meet straight away. So that I can acquaint you with the Council's own plans in that direction. Basically, we propose to set up our own police force.
What?
Set them on?
Yes.
Can you put it on? How are we doing? Is that a ball?
Yes, sir.
Yeah? So you live at number 7, yeah? On a green door?
Yeah.
With lots of people?
Yes.
What's that? It's a nice badge, isn't it? Does that mean anything to you? Yeah, it should do.
Steve, social services are coming to pick the kid up in half an hour. We're taking over anyway. You might as well get back out.
Right, thanks, June. With you in a minute, Reg.
Ah, oh, sorry, mate, don't mind me. You're the driver.
Is that the estate's office? This is Sunhill Police here, PC Loxton. Can you confirm the name of a tenant for me, please? For number 7, I think it's Winningdale Manor. Yeah, according to the voters' register, it's a Tara Webb.
I was over here anyway, public order meeting, so I just thought I'd pop my head round the door.
Oh, thank you, Dickie. It's nice to see a friendly face.
I've heard a whisper we could be amalgamated with Stafford Row. Well, if that's the case, 2-1 certainly doesn't go. Not at senior level. Who gets put out to grass? Look, Charlie, I know Sunhill and Barton Street have had their differences over the years. At an operational level. I hope the past isn't going to colour the advice you give to Hicks.
Me put the boot in, Dickie? Certainly not. That would be very unprofessional.
Nobody loves a smart ass, do
they? In the end, mate, there's only going to be smart asses left in this job. You'll be doing prisoner escort duty in the private sector. There you go.
You recognise it now?
Should be number 7.
Excuse me, love. Miss Tara Webb. Wait. Are you Miss Tara Webb?
Yeah.
You've got a little girl, she's about 3.
Yeah.
Do you know where she is?
Yeah. My boyfriend's taken her down the park.
Carly. Baby. I thought Rob had taken you to the park, Levy.
Rob?
Yeah, surname's Gilmore, apparently. Young lady's boyfriend.
Oh, and is Rob Carly's father?
No.
But he does live with you?
Not on a regular basis. Not that desperate. He stayed the night. I left him babysitting for an hour while I went to my cleaning job. Got home again and I was out. Then he often goes for a walk to clear his head.
And he hasn't been back since on his own?
No.
Seems he's quite heavily into alcohol. She reckons the Cranley Arms.
Hello again? Not this time, mate.
Tara's none too pleased. I think you're playing that as an ongoing leg-over situation.
Soppy tart.
You did take her kid burgling.
Burgling?
That's what you've been arrested for, Rob, remember? You do know what burglary is. Breaking into people's houses and stealing things.
Look, I was not burgling.
69 Askill Road. The back door had been forced. The officer on the scene saw you running out of it carrying a holdall.
The kid's balls were in it. The old doll. Football. Tennis balls. Sponge balls. We was going to the park, only I got caught short. I needed the toilet. Not for something you could do up a lamppost. Vindaloo and 8 pints of lager job. So I knocked at the door to ask if I could, you know. But there was no reply and I was desperate. And still a bit out of my skull from last night, I admit. So I busted the door, ran upstairs and used the bog. I forgot all about Carly. She must have followed me in.
Why did you run away then?
Perhaps he was just popping back for some toilet paper.
Rob?
Well, when you hear the ice cream van arriving, instinct takes over.
Oh, so you've been in this situation before then, have you?
No. I mean, I'm sure you've checked. I haven't got a record.
No, that just means you've never been caught.
See, I knew you wouldn't believe me.
No, no. It all sounds very probable to me. Doesn't it to you, Jane?
No, it doesn't. We'd like to search your home address, Rob, if that's all right with you.
Sorry, mate. She's such a cynic.
Morning, Stuart.
Hello, Derek.
Nice to see you still have faith in the Met.
Yeah, only because I worked in it for 30 years. Yeah,
that's very good, actually. Very good.
In actual fact, he's doing a good job.
Young PC99. And his mates.
Shoplifting's down 10%.
I told all due to the magic eyes.
Hello, Carol.
Donut or slice?
Ah, well, I think I'll have a slice. I'm trying to lose a bit of weight. Look, I've got a bunch of Swedish policemen coming over next month. They use cardboard cutouts on the streets of Stockholm. Perhaps I could bring them around, compare notes. Oh, the Swedes, I mean.
Yeah, of course.
Yes, I do want to farm them out as much as possible. They speak better English than I do. Sorry about that. Oh, it's the Nick. Can I...
Help yourself.
Cheers, Stuart.
Sir, it's Bob Cryer. Sorry to bother you. We've got a bit of a problem here.
Look, what do you mean you're a bit light on inspectors? I'll phone you back, all right, Bob?
What's up? Someone at it?
Fancy,
what the bloody hell do you think you're doing?
A spare bedroom.
Why aren't you on duty?
I swapped.
Who with?
Johnny Kendrick, C-team.
Well, I didn't see him this morning. Look, we've had a Section 18 to authorise and there's nobody in a nick to do it.
Sorry, but that's not my problem, sir. My annual leave form was signed by Mr. Cato and given to the duty sergeant. Excuse me.
It isn't much of a place. If I'd have known you were coming, I'd have tidied up a bit. Anyway, you won't find nothing, because there's nothing to find.
Yeah, I know you said.
Fancy a cup of tea?
No, thank you.
I'm out of tea bags anyway. I could pop down the corner shop.
No, I think we'll keep you just so we can see you, thanks.
There's nothing here.
Oh, Bob.
A bumblebee didn't go.
Yeah.
Well, there's been an interesting development.
Mr. Conway here, Polly. Could you repeat what you said to Sergeant Steele earlier, please?
A couple of the local residents have
come up and spoken to me. They've reckoned they've seen a man fitting Gilmore's description in the street before the burglary. Only there wasn't just a young child with him, there was a woman.
A woman?
What now?
You left Carly's jacket at the Nick. Can I come in?
Ah! Were you in Askill Road with Rob Gilmore this morning, Tara? Don't you go in there. I've just got off to sleep.
Come in with me. She into electronics as well as fuzzy felts, eh?
Yeah, we've been doing one or two a week. Pick a street, make out you're looking at houses for sale or whatever. Couple out with their kiddie. People like it. They trust you, especially the old crumblers. It's family values, innit?
So you suss out a target, then you and Rob go and do the business, yeah?
Well, it's quicker with two of us. And this morning it all went ape, so we legged it. I was out and gone before Rob.
And ran off and left your kid?
I thought Rob was bringing her. Anyway, she knows not to speak to strangers. I was going to claim her back.
Like a lost dog?
I'd just say she'd gone missing or something. But then them uniforms turned a pasky and suddenly I didn't know what the little prat might have said.
That's the trouble with kids, isn't it, eh? Think you brought them up properly, then they go and let you down.
See you at the dance register.
You're not on the team, mate.
Yeah, I've got a new set of errors, mate.
What, was it sticking aboard?
Oh, listen, child protection aren't going to be best, please.
Why's that?
Well, that kid nicked all the film.
Oh, yeah, nice try, Reg.
Oh, watch out, zip it about.
Good work, lads, good work!
Oh, thank you very much, sir. Enjoy your meal. Where is it you're going?
You think I'd tell you? I don't think you'd like it very much anyway, Reg. It's one of those places that give you two of everything to eat with.
Come on, even Robin Hood had to get used to a new set. As indeed Barton Street will have to.
Well, we reckon this is kosher, didn't it? The amalgamated Stafford Road?
Yeah, well, my sources tell me the job's still out of grabs. My Jerry Brown nose making the bullets, Sun Hill won't go under.
I don't see why not. There's no skin off his nose, is it?
Well, we'll be if he comes back.
Back? Brownlow? Well, I just got shot of him. Come on, Paul.
Tony, mate. All right, Paul. The job's not all straight lines anymore. It's all interconnecting circles. Of course, Conway's got the common touch with the troops and all that, but has he got the intellect of the 21st century?
I could always lend him your brain cell, Rich.
Cheers, Dave. Mine's a pint.
Yeah, big time.
All right, who's having what then? Come on.
Thank you. The thing is, Roy Lampart is right.
Rubbish. Absolute rubbish. Uniform patrol is a core police function. Charles.
Well, it always used to be considered a core police function, yes.
Why? What do you mean, why? Because we do it properly. We are highly trained, accountable professionals.
Yeah, but how highly trained do you need to be to walk up and down a pavement? Or have your shoes vomited on by some alky in a shopping precinct?
Oh, so we just become like the 7th Cavalry, do we? Sitting in our little forts. The last resort to call on when the cowboys can't cope? No. We control the streets, not some poncy security firm.
Look, deterring crime is all we're talking. And if Joe Public's willing to pay for it...
He already pays for it, Derek. He pays for you and me. You shouldn't have to pay twice.
No, but if he can afford to, he will. If it works. I mean, it's like private medicine, not education. He will pay for peace of mind, for results. He's not interested in your career prospects.
They've got private patrols in this neighbourhood, I believe. The residents pay £6 a month. They seem very happy with it. Mm. We've got to face the fact that nothing, absolutely nothing, is sacred anymore.
The area car, that'd be the next thing to go, Steve. All our expertise down the drain.
Yeah, well, at least the job will save on insurance.
What? How many? Class 4 driver on instant response. I mean, more pranks, not less.
Yeah, but get rid of the CID. That's ridiculous.
Well, some county forces already have their CID and their uniform sharing the same office space.
Actually, I think, as it all basically comes down to money, we should get rid of everybody in the job below the ranks here present, of course, and replace them with cardboard cutouts. Well, you don't have to pay them a pension, right? They can't claim overtime. They can't be accused of racist remarks, brutality, corruption, or anything else.
Derek, notwithstanding rank and this not being a taped interview, could I make a suggestion?
By all means.
Shut up and drink your wine. Zippy.
So did you get to see much of D.I. Johnson then when you were Bumblebee?
Not a lot, fortunately.
Do you think she'll survive, though?
Well, she's been acquitted of murder, hasn't she? I should think she's fireproof.
I hope not. I reckon she's been bad news from day one.
The doctor says, right, I've got some bad news and some bad news, right? So he says, what's the bad news? He says, you've only got 2 weeks to live. So he says, well, what's the bad news? He says, I should have told you 2 weeks ago.
So he says to him, what the hell are you doing? He says, spare room. You know what his face is like when it gets uptight? It's like a granite lemon squeezer, you know.
Yes! Come on, Stevie!
Come on, Steve!
Come on, Steve. Shh! Come on, Steve, you can do
it. Thanks, Reg.
Before we slag off any more of our nearest and dearest, I think it's time to propose a toast. Charles. Thanks for a splendid evening. We miss you at Sandhill. Remember us as you saw onwards and upwards to command a level and above.
Hey!
Hey! What's going on?
Back snatchers! Hey!
Don't worry. I'm paying.
Who the hell are you?
Council patrol. What's going on?
Citizen's arrest, mate.
Oh, right. I'll call the old Bill.
Yeah, you do that.